ورحمة الله وبركاته.
يا مرحبا الجميع. أولا أشكركم على الفرصة هذه. And إن شاء الله we'll start. My name is Hilal Luta. I'm the co-founder of Lune. And I'm going to start with a little bit of background behind what Lune is and why we started Lune. So Lune is your digital personal financial assistant that helps users track their spending, save for their goals, and invest for their future. Basically, Lune started from a personal issue that both Alexi, my co-founder, and myself faced in our previous careers in the Dubai courts, myself and Alexi in management consulting. And this problem was very simple. This issue was the fact that we found saving to be very difficult here in the UAE. We found the issue of tracking our finances to be cumbersome, and there's no tools, seamless tools to help us manage our finances. So we've built Lune as a mobile application that stands on three pillars: on allowing users to understand how they are spending their money, where they are spending their money, and what they can do to optimize their spending. So first of all, we give users an understanding of where they're spending their money through automatic categorization. And then we give them an interactive budgeting tool for them to understand how much they can save and how much they can spend. Now, we're looking to pilot our B2B product in a partnership with UAB. And Lune will allow UAB's customers to get control of their finances and optimize their saving and spending, and then in the end, optimize their investments through an interactive user experience, the automatic categorization, and the interactive budgeting tool. At the same time, it will allow UAB to start developing customer profiles and understanding exactly who their customers are, understanding how much they're spending, how much they're saving, and how much they can optimize for spending, while increasing their financial awareness, and help them automate their financial planning and saving goals. This is a very typical user persona and pain points faced by typical retail clients here in the UAE, where a lot of customers have issues with understanding where their money is going, where they can invest, and how much they can invest. And this is what we ultimately aim to tackle. Now, an integration with UAB could be on twofold. First of all, we can integrate an SDK if the user experience is of importance. Otherwise, we can integrate direct APIs. Users will log in via the normal UAB onboarding requirements and authentication requirements as required by the regulations. And the transaction and data will go through our engine. Now, where would this apply for UAB and their products? For example, we can start getting financial products pre-approved by, first of all, calculating the average monthly income of the user, their average monthly balances, and then starting to pre-approve them against the benchmarks of each specific financial product, making this targeting process much more efficient. Now, when it comes to investment targeting, the approach we're taking is that for users to understand how much they wish to invest and how much they should invest on a monthly basis to build a very long-term relationship with the client, users need to understand their whole finances to start with. Now, I'm talking about whether it's small retail clients to big clients. So our engine will identify their monthly cash inflows and calculate their monthly incomes, and then identify the overall monthly balance. And then we will seek to optimize their savings and maximize the monthly amounts that they could set aside for investment products. This will increase the frequency of their deposits as they go throughout the month and through the interactive user experience. This is a little bit of a background about myself. And Alexi, my co-founder, and we have our whole team inbuilt here based in Dubai. So thank you very much, and look forward to your questions.
Perfect. Thank you so much. Please. Hilal, I have a question. With regards, do you have any approval from central bank regulations with regard to the consumer protection?
Not at this stage. We're a software company that we're developing this, and we want to pilot it with the financial institutions, and then we'll look into these things.
So still you're not live in the market?
So with a financial institution, no. Not at this stage.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, يعطيك العافية خلال.
الله يعافيك.
Presentation ممتاز to the point. My first question to you, you have mentioned an SDK through our mobile app for UAB, right?
Yes.
What about online? So if I have an online user, they will, whenever they log into the online, they will have an integration directly to your app, or this is only to mobile?
No, we support online and web, but it really, in essence, depends on the systems of UAB. So if it's compatible or not, we'll have to look into it.
This is something important because we want to ensure that the feel and look is the same when it comes Absolutely. To mobile versus online. So we want to make sure that it will work for both platforms.
So our system supports both web and mobile. But so it does support.
All right. In regard to the data, because you're pulling tons of data from all over the UAB data platform, are you depending on an existing data warehouse or you have your own data modeling?
Currently, the way we've built it, so we've built the app, so it's operational on a B2C approach, and we're using AWS and cloud services. But as we understand, if we will integrate with a financial institution, that we have to adhere to the central bank requirements, as you mentioned, the consumer protection and the other data requirements. So we're aiming to move the AWS once they open the Abu Dhabi servers, to move it to the Abu Dhabi server to start with. But again, if there is a preference with UAB for different cloud providers or direct servers, then that's something we can definitely look at.
And my last question in regards to the data. I believe your app is providing an advisory recommendation on static data, but not dynamic data. So for example, you're going to be presenting a recommendation on my saving account, but you're not going to be pulling data from my credit card expenses to recommend how I should save, use more of a credit card. You see what I'm saying? Like, are you pulling dynamic data or static data?
So we pull transactions live, so both credit cards and bank accounts. So basically, just to explain it in a more simple way, let's take the use case of, myself, Hilal, for example. In the Dubai Cosme, for example, I had a specific salary. Lune analyzes how much you're spending every month on your credit card and on your balance. And starts giving you insights that, Lali, maybe you don't need to spend this much. Here, let's start setting aside this amount for this specific investment product, which is an investment product provided by UAB. This way you efficiently target and you efficiently maximize the product offering.
Got it. Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Any further questions?
Afwan Hisham, but my last question. So in the POC now, we're talking about the POC now, so we can compare apples to apples with the other vendors. You're proposing to provide a POC, right?
Yes.
And the time frame for the delivery of the POC?
So this, we really need to understand the systems of UAB. I can't understand before we look at the technical.
And high level, are we talking 3 to 6 months time frame? Yeah. Or?
Yes. Okay. Not longer than that, absolutely.
All right, that's excellent. Thank you.
Allah help.
Assalamu alaikum. I had one question about the sources of data. We are talking about a client that has maybe relationships with multiple banks. They have, for example, a relationship with Emirates NBD, and then they have their maybe salary with United, maybe Arab banks. So in this scenario, how you can track all the data, and is there a solution for this kind of maybe scenarios that?
So the proposition that we're proposing for a partnership with the financial institutions will confine this to the data within that specific financial institution. The reason being is that, as mentioned earlier, the consumer protection the new consumer protection regulations by the central bank is a little bit more tricky when it comes to exposing data from other banks to other financial institutions. So in our current proposition to UAB, it will be confined within UAB's banks, UAB's customers. However, we...
That's understood, but I think from maybe also ESCA point of view, whenever a recommendation is put for a client, his portfolio as a whole need to be considered. So this is something I think that need to be highlighted for any investment. For example, if you are recommending an investment in ETFs or in stocks, his whole portfolio need to be considered, I think, in this situation. So this is something that maybe you need to consider maybe going forward.
So from a, my answer was more from a, you know, the situation, the regulation situation, as I understand it, perhaps, of course, but from a technical perspective, then we can look at a solution for that situation.
Perfect.